In today's video, Morphe and Jaclyn Hill issue official statements regarding the reformulation of the Jaclyn Hill Volume 1 palette after it was discovered by Jen Luvs Reviews that the formula has changed and not for the better. That story coming up now. Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. I hope you're having a fantastic day today. If you're a return subscriber, I really do appreciate your continued support. If you're new here and you enjoy these types of videos, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Everyone give this video a big thumbs up, click on that notification bell and select it to all. That way you'll be notified when I upload my next video. Before we get started, and as always, I do need to remind you all that I am a drama commentary channel. I have opinions, and I speak them freely. Opinions are not facts, they never have been facts, and they never will be facts. Now that I've gotten that out of the way, let's go ahead and dive in. Last week, Jen Luvs Reviews uploaded a very important video to her channel called Why I Need to Take Down My Jaclyn Hill x Morphe Reviews. If you haven't checked it out yet, I highly suggest you do so you can get the full details, and I'll be sure to link it down below in the description box, but I'll also give you a quick rundown. Jen is very big on being open and honest with her subscribers, and when she learned that there had been a major change to the formula of the Jaclyn Hill x Morphe Volume 1 palette, she knew she had to speak up because it was the right thing to do. Jen's sister-in-law purchased the Jaclyn Hill Volume 1 palette recently, and she was saddened that she really wasn't impressed with the way it performed. Jen, who loves her Jaclyn Hill Volume 1 palette she bought when it first launched, was shocked to hear that her sister-in-law wasn't in love with it like she was. Fortunately, Jen's sister-in-law brought the palette with her, and the investigation began, an investigation that would reveal a shady, dishonest, and potentially harmful secret. Jen and her sister-in-law swatched the recently purchased palette aside Jen's original palette, and they quickly realized that they were clearly not the same. Some of the swatches of the same exact colors did not look alike, and the texture felt different. When Jen used the newer palette on her eyes, the eyeshadows, some of them, didn't perform nearly as well as they had in her original palette. Curious, Jen reached out to Morphe to see if, in fact, the formulation of the Volume 1 palette had changed like she suspected that it may have, and two different representatives from Morphe responded to Jen saying that the palette had not been changed from the original, and they suggested that they return the palette that they were not happy with. Unconvinced, Jen did what she does best and decided to dig deeper and found that Morphe had in fact changed the formula of the Jaclyn Hill Volume 1 palette, despite what she was told by the Morphe representatives. Several ingredients such as carmine, aka crushed beetles, coconut oil, shea butter, and I apologize if I get this wrong, but jojoba oil was added to the Volume 1 palette. Because of the change formula to the Jaclyn Hill x Morphe palette, Jen found that her previous reviews of the Volume 1 palette were no longer something she could keep up in good conscience, because if a viewer today decided to purchase the palette now, based on her reviews, they wouldn't get the same experience because the palette is no longer what it used to be. So, Jen put her previous reviews on private and did what was right and let her audience know what she had discovered. Word quickly spread around the community that Jaclyn's beloved Volume 1 palette had a formulation change and people were very disappointed. Zadidoll and Truth Sleuth, being the true investigators that they are, decided to do some digging into the formulation change because something wasn't sitting right, and people were coming for Jen saying that the addition of carmine and other ingredients really isn't a big deal, when in fact it really is to a lot of people for a variety of reasons. It wasn't long before Zadidoll and Truth Sleuth found, and then dropped, the mother of all incriminating receipts that quickly turned this palette drama into something far more serious. Morphe had promoted and sold the Jaclyn Hill x Morphe Volume 1 palette as a vegan product even after the formula had been changed to a non-vegan formula, and neither Morphe nor Jaclyn Hill publicly announced the change. Zadidoll tweeted, "If you bought a Morphe x Jaclyn Hill Volume 1 palette in 2018 or by December 15th, 2019, and the box lists carmine, you should sue Morphe for false advertising as they promoted it as vegan all the way into December 2019. At the very least, contact at Truth and Aid at AG Becerra, if I pronounce that wrong, I apologize, or the FTC. Make sure you thank True Sleuth for finding the smoking gun drama channels we're looking for. Yes, Morphe did promote it as vegan." Zadidoll and Truth Sleuth are correct that changing the formula from vegan to non-vegan and then continuing to market and sell it as vegan is no small matter. Not only is it false advertising and should be reported to the FTC for investigation, it is also a public safety concern. There are many customers who suffer from carmine allergies, and then there are also those that suffer from tree nut allergies, and the added addition of coconut oil is a major concern. Should consumers with allergies always double-check the ingredients? Yes, of course. But when Morphe promotes a product as being vegan because it doesn't contain such things as carmine, and then later on adds carmine to the palette without letting the public know, vegan customers and those with allergies that find themselves in need of a second palette for whatever reason may, and have, assumed that the palette is exactly the same as it was when it first launched in 2017 because they had never been told otherwise. Allergies aren't the only concern. Those that are vegan do not use products containing any animal products because it is a lifestyle that they have chosen to live either for religious reasons, moral reasons, or because of health issues. And being tricked into buying something that truly isn't vegan is inexcusable. It is false advertising, pure and simple, and Morphe needs to be held accountable. A large portion of Morphe customers and Jaclyn Hill supporters were furious when they learned that they may have unknowingly purchased a non-vegan palette, and they took to Twitter to express their anger, disappointment, and concern. Now, Jaclyn Hill hasn't come from this unscathed. Customers have been calling her out because not only is her name on the palette, but also because she had to have known about the change to the formulation since she bragged about the formula for her palette being solely her own that took her 2.5 years to develop, that she signed papers for, and no one else was allowed to use.
People ask me about that all the time because they're like, wait, what do you mean? Like, it's a different formula, because Morphe has their standard formulas and I created my own formula. There's actually been other people who've collaborated with Morphe who've asked if they can just use my formula, and they're like, sorry, that's Jaclyn's only. Like, I signed papers, it's my formula that I worked very hard on a couple of years back to develop.
Customers also came for Jaclyn because she very recently touted her new Volume 2 palette as being the same exact formula as her beloved Volume 1 palette, implying that it too is supposedly vegan since Morphe sold her original palette as vegan. For a time, Morphe did not address the situation other than to respond to a customer who left the following statement on their Instagram page. So, I want to know about the formula changes in the Jaclyn palette. Jen Luvs Reviews proved that she was lied to. To which Morphe responded, hi babe, thanks for reaching out. It's our goal to give you the best makeup ever. We know there was previous incorrect communications about our original Jaclyn palette formulas, and we wanted to clarify. Sometimes we reformulate things we already have in our lineup to ensure you get super pigmented, seriously creamy, and blendable shades you love. Now infused with jojoba, coconut oil, and shea butter. We only have your best experience in mind when formulating our products. If you have any further questions, please contact our customer service at, and then their phone number. Anyone else notice how they left out the carmine? Seeing that the criticism was not dying down, Morphe finally issued the following statement while Jaclyn Hill remained silent. We have seen several concerns about our original Morphe times Jaclyn Hill palette formula modifications and ingredient changes, and we want to set the record straight. We also want it to be clear that these formula improvements are out of our collaborators' control. Jaclyn was not made aware of the specific ingredient adjustments to her palette and was told only that we work to improve the performance and payoff. While it is common in the beauty industry to make formula adjustments and improvements to keep up with industry standards, it is not customary to announce them. The ingredients in our products are always posted on our website. However, we hear our customers' request for more clarity and promise to work to increase transparency in any formula modifications for the benefit of our customers. It has also come to our attention that a member of our customer service team shared incorrect information with Jen Luvs Reviews. We are using this as an opportunity to confirm that we indeed made formula modifications to Jaclyn's original Morphe palette. We apologize to Jen Luvs Reviews and our customers for this miscommunication and will work even harder to ensure our team share accurate information. We value everyone's feedback and will continue to always improve on your customer experience. The statement, as you can imagine, wasn't well received by a large number of customers. One upset customer tweeted, this isn't just changing a formula. Y'all left out the most important part in your notepad apology, the part where you're honest about switching the palette from vegan to non-vegan. Another individual tweeted, this brand is so shady. You still haven't mentioned the carmine and that it's no longer vegan, knowing damn well the formula is completely different. You let Jaclyn Hill tell everyone the Volume 2 is her special formula from Volume 1. The hell? Yet formula is similar to the vault? Get the F out of here. We're not stupid. And what company posts an official statement on their Twitter at 2 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on a Sunday? Seriously? Someone else tweeted, But didn't Jaclyn say her formula was like proprietary and she worked so hard on it for 2 years, even keeping it vegan without carmines, and that was a big selling point, but now it's not? Also, doesn't that make the reviews worthless? This disappointed person said, "Gotta say, this is disappointing. The vegan aspect of the palette was a huge selling point for many. The fact that it wasn't even addressed in this statement is extremely disrespectful to your customers, especially after Jaclyn just said it was the same exact formula in her video." An upset customer tweeted, "What upsets me about this is how are customers supposed to compare formula changes on a palette? Those formula changes are not disclosed. I bought the original Jaclyn Hill palette based on the rave reviews of the original formula. I feel deceived by this palette now. Are consumers supposed to track the formula of a palette that they want for weeks, months, years, capturing screenshots of ingredients for comparison? That's ridiculous. When the formula change affects the performance of the palette, this needs to be disclosed." This individual wrote, "Do you even realize how important it is for allergic people to know what the ingredients are? Apart from the fact that including carmine in a vegan announced formula should be a fraud." And then someone replied, "First thing I thought about, my friend is extremely allergic to animal products, proteins. A non-vegan product could land her in the hospital." And then finally, this upset person tweeted, "Here's the issue you're not getting at, Morphe Brushes. You claim this palette was originally vegan. Now it's not. No one cares about formula change. They care that it's now no longer vegan and or could be a health risk to people allergic to certain formulas and or ingredients." Zadidoll gave her thoughts as well. She tweeted, "Also, this statement by Morphe is a lie because people reached out to Jen Luvs Reviews with photos of their palettes purchased from Ulta Beauty or Morphe Brushes in 2018-2019, before the change, where the packaging lists carmine. This was when it was advertised as vegan." After being called out and accused of being a liar and a scammer that doesn't give two craps about her loyal subscribers and customers for a few days, Jaclyn finally, surprisingly, issued her own statement. She wrote, "In regard to all the conversation around my collaboration with Morphe, I would like to clear the air on a personal level. I was aware that they were increasing the performance of the product, pigmentation, and creaminess, but not made aware of ingredient changes. For those of you who don't know, you can change performance of a product without ingredient changes. I apologize to those of you who cannot use the palette due to the fact that it's not vegan. Although I am not vegan, I do understand the frustration, and I'm sorry to those of you." Jaclyn's statement did receive positive feedback from her stans. "Just ignore the haters, hun. Somebody's just jelly. We love you." Another person tweeted, "Girl, I wish people would just take your palette and be happy with it. You could just tell us to all go F ourselves and we never hear from you again. You do this because you love it and I love your palettes. Why people gotta be so mean?" This stan wrote, "Honestly, at this point, I feel like most of you are finding any little thing to negatively criticize on Jaclyn's products. Shake my head. You guys are so annoying. Go find someone else to attack." And then finally, this stan tweeted, "You owe zero apologies, Jaclyn. You put a great collab with Morphe and they found a way to screw it up and thought they'd leave you holding the bag again." Although she received some support, the vast majority of the comments she received were critical. "There's nothing increased about it. Apparently it's a lot worse now, and the fact no one stated it was no longer vegan is disgusting and a serious injustice to those people. To some, it's a big deal." Another person tweeted, "Why did it need performance enhancement? I thought you said it was the best and apparently the performance is worse now. As a collaborator, I'd be pissed." This individual wrote, "I love both palettes and you regardless, but I do find it a little hard to believe that you didn't know of the ingredient change when your new palette has carmine in it as well. So how did you not know of the change?" And then finally someone else said, "As a brand owner, I feel you should have known everything about the ingredient change. It is your collaboration with Morphe and you should have made it your business to know what ingredient they were changing. It's just irresponsible." Looking back on both statements from Morphe and Jaclyn, it's pretty easy to see why people are unhappy with how they both chose to address this very serious issue. First, Morphe. Not once did they address the fact that they changed the formula from vegan to non-vegan, and they didn't apologize for doing so while at the same time not telling the public about it. They also conveniently outed Jaclyn Hill, confirming that she knew the formula had changed. What Morphe should have said was, "We changed the original formula for the Jaclyn Hill palette back on such and such a date, and we sincerely apologize to our customers that are vegan and or have allergies. We acted very unprofessionally and promised to do better in the future to ensure the safety of all of our customers. If you purchased the non-vegan formula and would like a refund, please contact us." Their statement downplayed the seriousness of the situation and made it seem as if they actually don't care about their customers and were only doing mediocre damage control. Now on to Jaclyn's statement. In a word, lazy. It was lazily done and she took zero responsibility. It was clear that she only put it out because she had to. She didn't address the seriousness of the fact that people could have gotten hurt or ill from the change and that she would be working with Morphe to make it right. She didn't apologize for claiming that the new Volume 2 palette is the same original beloved formula as Volume 1 when in fact it isn't and she knew it. And lastly, she didn't apologize for the fact that she didn't properly research the process in which Morphe was going to enhance her palette. A company saying, hey, we're going to tweak the formula of your perfect palette you signed off on, but not tell you the details, and then you just go and say, okay, is grossly irresponsible, especially for someone whose reputation is already hanging by a thread as it is. It also doesn't seem believable. Like many others, I find it difficult to believe that Jaclyn Hill did not know that the Volume 1 palette went from vegan to non-vegan. There's two scenarios here. Either Jaclyn Hill is lying or she's incredibly ignorant. Given her tarnished past with being caught in lie after lie, it's easy to see why people don't trust her. How is it possible that she did not know that the formula had changed from Volume 1 when creating Volume 2? Did she not compare the ingredients? You'd think that a self-proclaimed perfectionist would. Many feel that it's time that Jaclyn Hill finally cut ties with Morphe, not only because every launch that she has seems to have an issue, but because they feel like she's only in it for the easy money and actually doesn't care about the products her name gets put on anymore. Where is the tutorial for the Volume 2 palette that she promised us weeks ago? Where is the closer look at the brushes? If the palette really meant that much to her, wouldn't she be excited to do looks for her channel with it? And it's reasons such as these that people believe she's only in it for the money. It's as if she only uploads when she has something to sell and then disappears again. And now it's time for my two cents on this situation, and I'm warning you now that it's going to be a long one. I find both Morphe and Jaclyn Hill to be shady and dishonest. Let's start with Morphe. Plain and simple, they lied to their customers and put out false advertising. The original palette was created to be vegan in 2017, the formula changed to non-vegan in 2018, and they continued to advertise it as vegan until 2019, as Zadidoll pointed out. Why the hell would they not let their customers know back when the changes happened? In my opinion, they didn't want their customers to know because they knew that 1, they would lose their vegan customers as well as those with carmine and tree nut allergies, and 2, because they actually did not improve the palette at all, so another lie. Generally, when a company legitimately makes improvements to a product, they market it as such. They are proud to announce the changes and even market the product with the phrase, new and improved formula. Morphe, however, did not, which to me says that they changed it because they were going cheap, not better. They wanted to save on the cost of making the palette but still sell it at the same price. The fact that Morphe didn't even have the common decency to publicly announce the formula change of the original palette from vegan to non-vegan just shows how shady, dishonest, and uncaring this company seems to be. They seem to be more about the money than the customers. Customers could have gotten seriously injured because of their lack of transparency, and maybe some have. People are allergic to carmine and others to tree nuts, such as coconuts, which is obviously found in coconut oil. Yes, customers with allergies should always double-check ingredients no matter what, but when a formula is promoted as vegan for years, you can understand why they would be upset. It's false advertising, and Morphe can get into serious trouble with the FDA. Their official statement was despicable. They tried half-heartedly to clear Jaclyn's name of all wrongdoing in all of this, but in reality, they just confirmed that she knew that the formula had changed. They also downplayed the seriousness of their lack of transparency by saying that they were just making the palette better for all of us and not even addressing the fact that they purposely changed it from vegan to non-vegan in 2018 and didn't change their website to reflect that change until 2019. They basically said, "We don't have to share all the details with all of you because you can just look it up for yourselves on our website, but from now on we will because all of you complained." Well, it may not be standard to disclose even the slightest change, but it's the right thing to do when you change a product so much that it can affect a customer's health or go against their morals or religious beliefs. Now on to Miss Jaclyn Hill. As I stated, I think that she's just as shady and dishonest as Morphe, and I'm sure her stans will come at me with their pitchforks, but honestly, I don't give a crap. Oh, stans, be sure to check out my The Dangers of Stan Culture video, by the way. Anyway, back to Jaclyn. She lied. She knowingly, willingly, unapologetically lied to her loyal subscribers. Undoubtedly, some of you are saying, how so? In her The Jaclyn Hill Palette Volume 2 Reveal and Swatches video, she said the following.
This is the same loved formula as the Jaclyn Hill Original Palette. This is the same loved formula as the Jaclyn Hill Original Palette.
This is the same loved formula as the Jaclyn Hill Original Palette.
A huge whopper of a lie. She knew damn well in her Volume 2 reveal video that the sister palette was not the same loved original formula as the first, but she went ahead and ran with that narrative, deliberately deceiving her subscribers, the customers. In her statement, she said, I was aware that they were increasing the performance of the product. So, she knew that the new palette was not the same loved original formula. She did go on to say, however, that she was not made aware of the ingredient changes. So, let's just say, okay, maybe Jaclyn didn't know that they added new ingredients to her original palette. How exactly do you go about improving the performance of a palette without changing the ingredients and formulation? So, was she lying before when she said that she had all of this control over the creation of the Volume 1 palette? Or is she lying now because she does have 100% control over the formulation of her palette and she did in fact know that they did change it from vegan to non-vegan? Jaclyn claims that she spent 2 years creating that formula. She signed the papers for it. It's hers and no one else can use it. Morphe has their own standard formula for every other palette and she has hers. She painstakingly tested each shade in her original palette, even going so far as to press shadows differently so they'd perform to the best of their ability. It's her formula, but she didn't know they were making ingredient changes? If it's your formula that you signed off on and you truly have 100% control of the formulation of your palette, doesn't Morphe have to tell you when they are changing the ingredients and the process so that you can sign off on it before it goes into production? This doesn't add up at all, and I'm calling BS. If she's truly not lying, then she is exceedingly ignorant when it comes to business, and honestly, I don't know which scenario is worse. Either that she's a liar, or she doesn't know what the hell she's doing. When Morphe told Jaclyn that they were going to increase the performance of the Volume 1 palette, did it never cross her mind to ask how they planned on doing that exactly? If I worked my butt off for 2 years on an eyeshadow formula, signed papers making it mine, and claimed it to be too perfect, you can bet I would be asking Morphe why the hell they felt they needed to change an already perfect and well-received palette when there is literally zero need for it. And you can bet I would be asking for the complete details on what they would be changing and how. As a self-proclaimed businesswoman, she should know that you never, never accept product changes without getting the full details first. You don't just go okie dokie. Expect people to try and take advantage of you and do you dirty. It's irresponsible and naive to take things at face value. When the changes were made, did she bother to even ask for samples to test them out before the changes went into full production? As a self-proclaimed perfectionist, you would think that she'd be extremely concerned with the possibility of the performance being altered. The slightest change can make a world of difference in formulation. When she would have gotten the sample, she would have immediately noticed that the texture felt different from the original and that the swatches do not match the ones from the original palette. When Jen Luvs Reviews took the time to compare the two palettes side by side, she found that the quality and performance were subpar compared to the original palette. Why didn't Jaclyn Hill do the same? Aside from asking for samples, why didn't she ask to see the list of ingredients? She signed the papers on the original formula, so you know she had the original list of ingredients. Why didn't she take the time to compare them? Also, why didn't she compare the ingredients of the Volume 2 palette with the original Volume 1 palette to make sure they are indeed the same? Of course, it is a possibility that she did all of these things and they are just lying about it now because they've been caught. There are a lot of customers that have a lot of questions and are very confused about this whole situation. Since we are unlikely to get any real answers from either Morphe or Jaclyn regarding all of our questions, someone asked Kevin James Bennett, a consumer advocate in the cosmetic industry and also a cosmetic developer, if it's even possible to change the product without changing the formula. This person tweeted, "So is it possible to increase the performance and creaminess and not change the formula?" To which Kevin replied, "No. Even if it's the same ingredients, once ingredient percentages are manipulated, it becomes a new formula. And once the order of the ingredient list changes, all product packaging, printed materials, and the website must reflect the change." As I said before, things are not adding up, and no matter which way you look at it, it paints Jaclyn Hill in a very negative light. every single launch she has had, whether it be in collaboration with another company or even her own brand, has had something go wrong. It's an ongoing theme, and her go-to excuse is, "I didn't know." Jaclyn, it's your job to be in the know, and that excuse wore itself out many, many launches ago. If you want to be taken seriously, you need to step up, because as of right now, you appear to be incompetent when it comes to business, and it's further tarnishing your name, and it's making it hard for people to trust you. As hard as this may be to believe, I actually do not hate Jaclyn Hill. I am indifferent to her. I want her to succeed in her dreams, and I really hope that she does. And to do that, I think it's high time that she cut all ties with Morphe. Morphe is a shady, shady company, and it would benefit her greatly to just step away. She also needs to stop it with the lies. Morphe allowed, stood by and watched as Jaclyn Hill touted her Volume 2 palette as being exactly the same as the original Volume 1 palette when it comes to the formula. For a company that claims to love Jaclyn Hill, they sure didn't mind watching her either lie on camera or accidentally put out false information. A true friend, a true company that actually cares, would have corrected her and set the record straight so she didn't look stupid or come off looking like a giant liar. She is the CEO of her own company now, and she needs to focus all of her attention on Jaclyn Cosmetics, especially after Lipstick Gate. It's going to take time, a lot of time, to repair the damage that has been done to her image, and she absolutely cannot do that while she is still attached at the hip to Morphe. If they are somehow connected to her own company, I hope that she can find a way to break away completely. Jaclyn isn't innocent in all of this. I still believe that she is shady and is quick to lie to save her own butt, but I do believe that Morphe has taken full advantage of Jaclyn's lack of knowledge in business and naivety. So, to summarize, I feel both Morphe and Jaclyn Hill are equally at fault in this entire mess. Morphe, do better. We consumers aren't stupid, and you will always get caught eventually. Jaclyn, if you've been lying about this the entire time, stop. You're only hurting your credibility more, and we will find out like we have in the past, and you will be called for it every single time. If you haven't been lying, please take the time to properly educate yourself on business so that you can flourish in the future. Don't just rely on people you think you can trust and take their word for it. Double check and question absolutely everything. Not everybody has your back. Not everybody cares about you succeeding. Don't be naive. I know this topic is going to generate quite a discussion in the comments down below, and that's fine by me as long as you all remember to remain respectful to one another. Remember that we can all have our own opinions regarding this topic and still be respectful adults about it. Name calling and personal attacks solve absolutely nothing and only prove that you have no argument to stand on. Please be kind. Thank you. Well, that's going to do it for today's video. Again, I'd like to thank you all so much for spending some time with me today. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your evening. Remember, if you are new here and you enjoy these types of videos, be sure to subscribe to my channel. Everyone give this video a big thumbs up, and I will see you very shortly on the next one. Bye!